Welcome back to the channel, it's the Prevengers, your guys, and welcome back to another Marvel Future 5 video. Today we're going to be going over the January update sneak peek and basically everything else you need to know about this January update. So we're going to start breaking it down here. I could have split this up into multiple videos, but we decided to just put them all in one. So first off, we're going to start with the January update celebration live stream post that they gave us about 3 days ago. So three days ago, they hit us with this on Instagram, Twitter, everything, with basically this image, a live stream for the update on January 12th at 6 p.m. Pacific, so 9 p.m. Eastern. This is uncover this new hero in the January 12th live stream. And it gives us this character with a giant question mark on it. And for the past 3 days, basically, sorry about that, the past 3 days, people have just been guessing left and right to try and figure out who this new character is, and we actually got our answer with the sneak peek, so we'll dive right into that. But just so you know, the live stream, which is going to answer a lot more questions, because I'm going to be honest here, I'm not going to answer all your questions in today's video. I'll probably be answering more of them tomorrow after the live stream, because we are still left with a lot of question marks for this update. But make sure not to miss this January 12th at 9 p.m. I will be in an Apex tournament, so I will be watching it 30 minutes after, so depending how long the live stream is, I'll be watching it back and then making a video right after on it as soon as I get my first thoughts. The other big news that came out around that day is that all Star Creator members, so of course I'm not in that just yet, fingers crossed it happens this year, but one of my friends, obviously Daily Marvel Future 5, if you know him, make sure to check him out on Twitch as well, I'll leave a link for that. But basically, they were all emailed with this same message saying, "Greetings, agents. The CM Fragment. This is the Star Creator Club Club Manager. Sorry, I'm used to saying CM Fragment. We'd like to share the latest news of the Marvel Future 5 January update with our Star Creators who always make great videos. We are excited to announce the upcoming release of a new Epic Quest, which many of our agents have been looking forward to." So, telling us that this update will include that Epic Quest that they had promised us back at, like, towards the end of December. They gave us a notice on the forums telling us there will be new World Boss Legends, a new Epic Quest, all this great stuff, and the January update will include this new Epic Quest. And up till today, we've been guessing who's going to be in the new Epic Quest, but we finally have our answer. So without further ado, let's go ahead and watch the January update sneak peek number one. And there you have it. There is the sneak peek. So now that we've let you watch it once, let's go ahead and break down what we see here. So first of all, we're in this nice little area. Looks like just some islands in the middle of the ocean. A little bit of paradise type trees. And we see five figures. We see a Jean-like figure, which, calm down, it's not a new Jean uniform. A lot of people were saying, oh no, it's tier 5 Jean, new uniform. She's going to break the game. No. Calm down, it's not Jean. I'll get into who that is, but she basically has a throne. She's flying mid-air. We see four other figures, and we have some language that's down here on the bottom that is translated into English, the island of Croca, which is interesting. Then we get a better look at these characters, and we have four of the characters that are going to actually be included in this Epic Quest. We have, of course, Exodus, who is that cover of the live stream post they gave us. We have Rachel Summers, so she should be getting a new uniform and a Transcendent or Tier 3 in this update. We have Havoc, who is finally being added to the game. It's about time. He was actually in a lot of votes in the past couple years of which character we wanted to be added to the game. And he was heavily talked about all the time, and we are finally getting him in the game. And then right here, we also have Hope Summers, which is somehow related to Rachel Summers. Apparently, there was a lot of different Summers in the Marvel comics, and it gets pretty complicated, actually. So I am surprised to see such a niche character get added, but it's still pretty darn cool. So what does this mean Oh, wait, we're missing one character, sorry. So after we see them all power up, we see Rachel Summers put her hands on fire. We see Havoc sort of charge up. We see Hope Summers put on her fire, and it looks a lot like Jean Grey, and I'll explain that in a sec. Then we said Exodus's power, which is really purple and flamey in his hand. And then we have none other than not Jean Grey, but the Goblin Queen, also known as Madeline. I forgot how to say her name. Let's see. Madeline Pryor. So Madeline Pryor, aka the Goblin Queen, as you can see down here, will also be included in the Epic Quest. And so just to give you a little background, I did a little bit of research. So obviously we all know who Rachel Summers is. She's in the game. We've been talking about Havoc forever. Hope Summers is the only one that I don't have much information on. The only thing I know about her is that she is actually a not a clone, but it has descendants powers of Jean Grey. So she gets her powers from Jean Grey. It was kind of like a mutation. It's weird. It's complicated. With X-Men, it got really weird at a certain point. But she has Jean Grey's powers, so we can see her being pretty powerful. And then we have Exodus, who we talked about. I don't think we actually talked about it, but he actually gets his powers from Apocalypse. So him, I probably know the most about. He was with his friend. They go into a pyramid, and he gets possessed by Apocalypse, and then Apocalypse gives him powers. And then he basically becomes this villain with Magneto for a cool while. So yeah, just so you know, a little bit of background on him. And then we have the Red Goblin, who is a like actual clone of Jean Grey, who's a separate character in Marvel Future or in Marvel Comics, and I'm assuming Marvel Future Fight as well. So if I had to guess here, right, Exodus is probably gonna be that six. So you know how like the Epic Quest always have a character that costs crystals, right? So I'm assuming he's gonna be the 6,600 crystal cost because he's supposed to be very strong. Like he went toe to toe with Professor X, so he's supposed to be pretty strong in the comics. So I'm assuming that's gonna translate to game. I think Rachel Summers is gonna just have the uniform for this update in the tier 3, and then I think both of these characters are gonna get introduced as, obviously they're new characters, so they're gonna get introduced in that Epic Quest. How you are able to unlock like Thing and why can't I think of his name, Human Torch, in the Fantastic Four Epic Quest. All those characters that you can unlock from the Epic Quest, I believe these two will be those characters that you can unlock. And then your final reward, which like in the X-Men one it's Jean, in the X-Force it's Strife. I'm trying to use all the different examples. I believe she will be that final character once you have all of them upgraded to their max. She'll be the final character you can get and will probably be the most overpowered and strong out of these characters. Now, what makes it interesting and why we're all very excited to see this live stream tomorrow is because it still leaves a lot of questions. So obviously we can see Rachel getting the tier 3 of the Transcendent. That answers who's going to get that. But the big question is, who's going to get the tier 4? Is it going to be her? Are they going to take her straight, introduce her straight from one star all the way to tier 4? Or is it going to be Exodus who actually gets the tier 4, being that he's the 6,600 crystal character? I don't know, and that's what a lot of people are trying to figure out, who the tier 4 is, because it's kind of clear we got the two new characters. We have the new uniform and upgrade, right, to tier 3. We have the 6,600 crystal character. And then we had the final Epic Quest reward character. But who is the tier 4 in this update? And that's going to be what I hope they answer tomorrow. Another thing that a lot of people are talking about is what the rewards are going to be for the 6,600 bundle. What's going to be included in that. And once you usually buy those packs, you are able to play these other game modes. So for like the X-Men one, the Magneto, you are able to play the Magneto mode and get his bios and some feathers and stuff. So people are wondering if maybe we get a little bit of tier 4 mats involved somewhere there. If she is, in fact, going to tier 4, it would only make sense. But I guess we'll have to wait and see. And assuming she's going to be a native tier 2, she's going to be pretty darn expensive. So we'll see how it goes. They might even make her just a native tier 3. I don't know. It's going to be very interesting to see what happens here. But this is going to be the start to, obviously, it's a start to a brand new year for Marvel Future Fight. But it's going to be a start for, I feel like, some huge changes in the game to come. Because if she is really good, she can potentially take out characters like Jean and Adam and all these other meta characters. You know, every time a new Epic Quest came out, those characters were super, super heavy meta forever. Sentry was meta. Jean is still meta right now. Strife is now finally getting his time in the meta. Some didn't get their justice, but others did. Makari was meta. Athena was meta. Gilgamesh was meta in our last epic quest with the Eternals. So yeah, there's a lot of potential here. A lot of these characters could be very good, and I'm really excited to see what they can do. So now we talked about what they can do in the game, let's go ahead and read what they had to tell us. So the Goblin Queen, powerful mutants and new heroes have gathered to fight against the Queen who can alter reality. So she has some of the same powers as Jean, not all of them. I believe she has like half of Jean's powers, and then Hope Summers has the other half, so it's kind of weird. But we'll see how they played out in the game. So greetings, agents. This is CM Fragment of Marvel Future Fight. Powerful mutants and new heroes have gathered to fight against the Queen who can alter reality, the Goblin Queen. Check out the new looks and abilities of these mutants with extraordinary powers. We'll announce more information through the update details later. Meaning that this is the only sneak peek we're getting, which kind of makes sense considering there's literally five characters in it. So all we have to look forward to is the live stream tomorrow. And then we will get patch notes probably either Monday night or Tuesday night. I'm not sure when they're deciding to push this out, especially because I can never remember what the time zone conversion. But I will give you guys a heads up, just me personally here on the channel. I am leaving on a trip Saturday, so I'm going to have pre-recorded videos for you guys Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday I get back, so a day after the update. So we're probably going to skip out on the patch notes video unless I have time to make one while I'm out there. Most likely not, but we'll see. And then we're just going to have to dive right into the update when I get back because I'll already be a day late. So apologies for that. But it was just kind of bad timing with, like, you know, me leaving and the update coming out. It is what it is. But we're going to make sure to do this live stream. Tomorrow will be our last video before we leave. And like I said, we already have a bunch of pre-recorded videos for you guys. We had a lot of catching up to do anyways. So it worked out fine. But other than that, that's pretty much all the info I got for you guys. It's an exciting time in Marvel Future Fight, I'll tell you guys that, because new epic quests always mean, obviously, time to grind those rewards, and once you can unlock them, time to do tons of review videos, or time to go watch a ton of review videos, depends, you know. So we'll see how it goes. I don't currently have enough crystals to buy out the epic quest, but I, of course, will be making videos checking out all these characters. And depending what Rachel Summers looks like, we could also buy her uniform. We'll see. I'm not sure what I'm going to do yet, but I definitely want to explore a lot into this epic quest when I get back, so I'm very excited for that. But anyways, guys, that'll do it for my breakdown for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did find this helpful or entertaining, then please consider leaving a like and subscribe to the channel, guys. We're only 65 subs away from hitting 1,000, which is huge, and then we can apply to the Star Creator Program, so I'll be able to push out notices like that to you guys a lot faster. We'll be able to do a bunch of other fun stuff. So anyways, that'll do it for today. Have a great rest of your day, guys, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.